Roger, the Hutchinsons thought they had made it through the worst of the storm, but the heavy ice was just too much for this barn, knocking it down, and this is what's left. The concern now is where to house these alpacas and the possibility of losing these animals altogether.
When we came home, the building had collapsed. Most of the animals were fine except for one who was pinned. She was an 8-month-old little girl.
Rosie didn't survive, but for the dozens of alpacas who did escape this barn collapse yesterday, they're now left in the cold.
First part of moving animals. We're going into the next door van because she's a little skinny and she's really shivering. So we're going to put Jezebel in the car. They're going to go just north to a farm, Willamy Alpaca Farms, Wind of Willamy's, customers of ours. So here are all the little babies and your little poncho, Don. Is this little guy right here? That's Poncho.
Right on, Poncho.
Yeah. So anyway, these guys are going to their temporary shelter, and it's a cold day today. All these guys are shivering, so this is a necessary move. Thanks for watching. Hey guys, Nancy from One Stop Alpaca Farm, and it's really cold this evening. It's supposed to get down with the wind chill to minus 31 tonight, and there is a bit of a wind, and if the tarp goes up, you can see it starting to really shred. I am so grateful and so thankful that the animals are no longer on this farm and tucked away in safe barns, and I really like to thank everybody that's helped us to get the animals, and those who have volunteered. Highland Creek Training Facility, we've got Racing Horse Farm, and Winds of Willamine. They've taken some of the babies, so those farms, thank you. Hey everyone, it's Nancy from One Stop Alpaca Farm, and I just put this sign up as a thank you to everybody who's helped us emotionally get through this crisis. And you know, when this all happened December 26th, it was sheer tragedy. On the 27th of December, when the insurance said they weren't going to cover it, I was devastated and flat out, I guess, deflated. But with everybody rallying behind us, I'm so thankful for everybody reaching out to us. And anyway, I just want to thank you for everything everybody's done for us and the farm. And looking forward to better things that fall together. So this is kind of a thank you to all the support we've been getting.
and I'm empowered and ready to go forward. So anyway, thanks for watching.